1212, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Black Women's Expo 2018. I need y'all to make some noise right now. How's everybody doing over here on my right? Y'all make some noise. How's everybody doing over here on my left? Y'all make some noise. How's everybody doing right here in the middle? Y'all make some noise. That's what I'm talking about. I like that. We are the Poet Organization, P-O-E-T, People of Extraordinary Talent. Who are we? Who are we? We have members of the organization that range from 10 years old to 75 years old. We have members of the organization from Ghana, Africa, from Jamaica, Montego Bay, Hobima, Alberta, Canada, and the United Kingdom, and of course, all throughout the United States. And everywhere we go, we not only do poetry, we not only do song and dance, but we feed the hungry, we clothe the poor, we give scholarships out to young people, further their education, we mentor at the Chicago public school system, and also in Detroit and everywhere where we are. Give it up for that, y'all, because that's what you call turning your words into what? Into action. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to kick things off with my sister, who goes by the name of Miss Gifted. Let's go.
Children, hold on to your dream. Believe.
Those of us, we live in my south. At 8 miles south, we can't even score alone.
warm summer day because of shots to the back and he's insane. Hey y'all, people are dying left and right, dying at night for rolling the dice. And me and Ice comes back to bite. It's death and destruction, the killers keep coming. Tears, fears, shattered dreams, and mother screams. Because life's a struggle, a cycle of trouble, and all too often, some souls are sold and traded up for white gold. White lies in the minds, is it the sign of the times? It's open wounds that bleed like rain. Oh, what a shame that well-planned schemes are the ultimate dreams. And a mother cries, because in her dreams, all she sees is two dead eyes looking at hers, praying for her son's demise.
I live the street life, because there's no place I can go. You can pay your life away.
He became a modern day Picasso. Red, blues, blacks, greens. He used the face as a canvas on which he painted. Now she's using an 8x10 scale, wondering why he doesn't write. Maybe it's because with each and every stroke there was silence. I said with each and every stroke there was silence.
I'm telling you, you see the rock, but you don't see see the hand that throws the rock. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Mark Prophet and Miss Firekeeper. This group of individuals must be stopped before they take over. They practice togetherness, unity, mind stimulation, but their minds must be made over. If we bring down the head, then the body will fall afterwards. So let's aim at their leaders and hope that progression moves backwards. Their women depend on the men, which keeps the family together and sets the example for the children. This is going to cost us some money, but now you don't need the men. We gave you free food, money, living. What have we done? Now the families are saving money, forming groups, and the fathers are still the sustainments. Let's minimize their job opportunities. Give the groups drugs to sell and take away good times, then glorify black entertainment. This is our project, forming families where the mother is the president. And to benefit from the projects, the father cannot be a resident. They're falling. And if we continue this process, their children will be lost and devastated. There will be no structure. Mothers will be single, and fathers who sell the drugs will be incarcerated. Let's never tell them it was kings and queens, but only slaves from a place filled with poverty and dissatisfaction. Make them think they're useless. And we're superior. Because you control one's thinking, you control one's actions. One, two. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for that one more time, y'all. Give it up for that one more time. It's a trap, ladies and gentlemen. And we got to let our young people know that it's a trap. Don't you know how many people benefit from the mayor in Chicago? We got judges that benefit. We got lawyers that benefit. We got ambulatory services that benefit. We got morgues that benefit. We got state lawmakers that benefit, all from what's going on in our community. It's a big business. If they wanted the crime to stop, they know how to stop the crime. But long as it's not going downtown, as long as it's not going to some of the other places, as long as they can contain it to the west side and the south side of Chicago, it is no threat. I want you to wake up, my people. But I need to know one thing. Who up in here is proud to be black? I need to understand like y'all mean it. Who up in here is proud to be black? Ladies and gentlemen, this Firekeeper.
I struggle to be humble in the presence of those not as black as me, not as melanated, pigmented, elevated. God created black as me. I understand the universe is made of 95% dark matter and dark energy, like me. My blackness protects me from the sun. I try not to boast of my blackness and the sun and our affinity, but being richly melanated, I understand. I hold the secrets to the universe, the essence of divinity. Therefore, I struggle to be humble in the presence of those not as black as me. And I have learned a polar bear, for instance, appears to be black. But if you shave the hair off a polar bear, you'll find he's black as me. This body absorbs the energy from the sun. The energy converts to heat. His blackness keeps him warm. All this time we thought that his fur keeps him warm. But that's not right. That's not right. His blackness keeps him warm. I struggle to be humble in the presence of those not as black as he. Not as melanated, pigmented, elevated. God created black as he. I understand the universe is made of 95% dark matter and dark energy, like me. His blackness in the Arctic keeps him warm. I further learn, a beautiful zebra appears to be striped, black and white, but is that right? If you shave the hair of a zebra, she's black like me. Her blackness absorbs, emits the energy of the sun. In other words, her blackness keeps her from getting too warm. Therefore, I struggle to be humble in the presence of those black as sheep. And you know about the black crow
I cross my heart and hope to die if I should lie. It's the smartest bird to ever fly in God's sky. This bird can talk, and they can use telepathy. But because it's black, it has a bad rep and my sympathy. Therefore, I struggle to be humble in the presence of those not as black as it. If you understand the words coming from my mouth, it's a deep sugar, and it's sweet, and it's deep. Whether red bone, tan, or ebony, if the old folks come from Africa, we be family. And we cannot let Woody Lynch's plan stay true and separate ourselves because of color or our hue. We be family. Thank you.
Yes. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to bring you some real energy and some real fire right now. Please put your hands together for Mr. Word Warrior and Queen Dina from the 313 Detroit, y'all. Let's go. I breathe through my ink. I breathe through my words. This is how I think. Poetry is my breath. Poetry is my life. This is how I breathe. This is why I write. Experiences in life that make me tear tonight. I breathe through my words if they're wrong or right. With every essence of my soul. Sometimes these words just take control. Oxygen and air, we really can't go there, because poetry is my breath, nothing else I care. It's the foundation of my brain. Poetic lyrics will always remain. My every ounce of energy, I owe it all to poetry.
The power of a woman will turn the world around. The girl is strong when man is down. I'm not prejudiced, I'm provoked. I've been brought up in a country where my rights were revoked. I'm the real of a man in the back, known of a race. I'm not intimidated by the smells of another human's face. They try to take my pride, my mind, my soul, by raping my brain and stripping my clothes and steal. I find the strength to keep my family's heart whole. Today, entity seek women to devour it, but set sail for tomorrow, for we will prevail tomorrow. And all they'll lean on is the woman's power. Put your power in, yeah. As I elevated from a lady to a queen, I rode heads like no one has ever seen. You rubbed me wrong. I was sure to get greasy and mean. A warrior, my heart, it's down in my jeans. The thoroughbred soldier, scrap, fight, smile. A passed down order chosen to walk the green mile. At the head of the table, you must keep your mind stable. Put your power in, yeah.
Of God's creation, I gave birth to nations, the manifestation of God, mother of all civilization. You see, I am the culmination of every great woman that has ever walked this earth, and I call upon her energy at my will. For instance,
have the power to bewitch your minds with verbal and visual pleasantries. I, my pretty, am Eartha Kitt.
I am the fire within your core that makes your arms rise and your hands twist into a fist, liberating minds and society. You may call me Angela, my sisters. You've been on my mind, sisters. We're two of a kind, so sisters. I'm keeping my eye on you. I am the melanated epitome of grace, style, intelligence, and power. I gave birth to nations while my melanated king ran the nation. I speak what I mean and I do what I say. You see, my queendom is legendary. You may call me Michelle.
Draw a picture of his hero. And I've been thinking for a moment about who made the most De Niro. He drew a picture of me in the mirror. Came home and posted it on the refrigerator door. When I saw it, it touched me to the core. I was outdone. Yes, nothing more than a father wants to hear than admirations from his son. So that night as I tucked him in, I wanted to be crystal clear. So I sincerely whispered in his ear, "Son, I love you." And your honor, with his hands in front of his mouth, he said, "Daddy, I love you too." As he laid in front of me, I was touched. It was like a needle had stuck me in my arm and my blood was right in front of me. So I thought to myself, I wonder, does he really know for me what he has done? And does he know that I never could have been a father until he made me one? And that until he was born, I never really knew me. And that I didn't know a thing about responsibility until he gave it to me. And that until he was born, my future was kind of dim. But now that he's here, my life has been extended. Because even when I'm gone, I can live through him. And although how far he has come, and despite all the obstacles, everything that he has achieved and done, my son may consider me to be his hero. But to me, my hero is my son.
Gifted.
This sister right here is starring right now in the hit stage play called King of Policy at the Harold Washington Cultural Center. She goes by the name of Miss Analog Soul. Please give it up for Analog Soul. This brother right here, one of our Eagle One legends, he goes by the name of Big Mike. Please put your hands together for Big Mike. We got one more person, right? Miss A Symphony, y'all. She just made 17 Thursday. She's a classical opera singer. Please give it up one more time for Miss A Symphony. Holding it down is our vice president right there. Please give it up for Miss Black Isis right here making sure we get it. And I am the CEO and founder of the POET movement. My name is Black Ice, poet activist. Thank y'all so much. We love you, Black Women's Expo. Who are we?
Pirate!
Who are we?
Pirate!
Oh, we got books and CDs right over here on the table on the side. See these young ladies over here to the left, please.